But we're back with Katrina Vandenhoevel.
This ascendancy. This ascendancy, or to be glib about it, the springtime for strong men. I think it's imperative that we look at the roots. And the roots are racialized. There is a kind of Volk, to use, you know, a land sovereignty, nationalism of the worst kind. But there's also a sense of people being displaced, being left behind, of an economy that has worked for the elite, not for them. And I think it's important to try to speak to some of those people to try and take back the noise from a Donald Trump or those like a Duterte or Orban. It's very complicated, but one thing we're trying to do at The Nation, and I know Bernie Sanders at the end of this month is convening a kind of gathering to begin to build a left international. You got to build, you got to counter something with something. There is the right wing international, and I think to find a way to gather the forces around the world which see a different way forward, and to put on offer an alternative, and not just a no, but what is our yes, is a beginning. And he's having people from Podemos, the Spanish left party, Yanis Varoufakis, part of Syriza in Greece, Labor Party. I was just meeting with someone who's going to be part of the new López Obrador government in Mexico, which some, you know, which is exciting. And I think Jeremy Corbyn can't go to the Bernie meeting because he's going to Obrador's inaugural gathering. So I'm just saying, I think we need, and the nation is committed through its journalism and maybe events, to thinking hard about how you rebuild a global progressive left that has at its root very different principles that could counter the ascendancy.
Internationally and historically, there have been two groups that have been characterized as the left. There was the old communists, right? The Soviet Union and China, et cetera. Vietnam still is. And then there was the democratic socialism of Northern Europe.
And there was the non-aligned movement, to be fair. The countries who were not caught in the thrall of the Soviet Union or China and weren't certainly caught in the thrall of unfettered predatory capitalism of the United States. But you're right, the Nordic countries, the social democratic forces in Europe. But I would argue also in Asia and Africa, the non-aligned movement was an important one.
I agree. But where I was going with that is that in retrospect, it appears that the, quote, communist movement really wasn't a movement of the left. It was really an authoritarian movement under the guise of the left. Yes, we'll give you a job, we'll give you a home, we'll give you education, we'll give you all that free stuff that supposedly comes from the left, and then we will rule with an iron fist and destroy the press. That's not the left.
No, and I think to confuse it with the left has become a right-wing project today.
It's a major
And I
trouble.
Think a new generation, which we've seen the polls, you've seen them, Tom, a new generation which grew up in the wreckage, the ruinous wreckage of the financial crisis, has identified itself more as democratic socialist, as did Bernie Sanders. I think there's a power to that, a real lived experience, but I think it requires a lot of public education to speak to other generations, which sadly often do associate socialism with the Soviet Union or, as Fox tells us every night, Venezuela, or to be, we had a wonderful story by Kate Aronoff about the Council of Economic Advisors. Did you see this about 2 weeks ago? Where they were so frightened by socialism that they did a 60-page report, essentially an analysis of how Venezuela has failed, and that is socialism. I mean, so there's a lot of work to be done.
Yeah.
But democratic socialism among younger people is a force to be reckoned with.
Let's continue this conversation. Katrina Vandenhoevel is with us. We're at the offices of The Nation magazine in New York City. We'll be right back.